first have the Vice President Education give us an update on the meeting roles open for next week.
Good evening, everyone. All the roles for next week are open, and I request members to contact me for any role that you wish to take up. Thank you, and back to the president.
Thank you, Rohan Spoorthy, for that update. For the business session, I have a few updates to give all of you. Firstly, yesterday we had the club officers training program, and almost all the club officers have attended the same. I would request all the club officers to be ready with the learnings, to summarize your learnings from the COTP in the next week's meeting on 17th January. We will be summarizing all the learnings from the COTP, so please be prepared for the same. Secondly, like you all are aware, the contest season is around, and to help all the aspiring participants, the district has organized a series of workshops called the Speech Analysis Workshops. So as of now, two workshops are completed, and I had attended both of them, and they were very enriching. So I would request all the members to please register for the same and make the maximum benefits out of it. Also, the district is organizing a judges training program for all those who would like to judge in the upcoming contest season. So if you would like to attend, please do attend the same. It's happening on 26th of January. The link will be sent out shortly. I will be updating on the group as well. Also, we do get Hall of Fame points if you attend the workshops and the JTP. So I request members to please do attend the same. This time, we will be having all the three contests, that is the speech contest, evaluation contest, and the table topic contest. The club contest will be happening in the month of Feb sometime. We will be updating the exact dates on the group. I would request all the members who would wish to participate to start preparing for the same. Lastly, on Saturday, that is the 8th of January, our immediate past president, Toastmaster Sai Snehal, had done a webinar on hybrid meetings. The webinar was a great success. Not only that, we had a lot of participation from the members of Mekong Communication Club, which I'm sure motivated Sai Snehal a lot. So thank you, Sai, for conducting the webinar and for representing Mekong so beautifully well. With this, I would end the business session and now hand it over to the Sergeant at Arms, Toastmaster Vaishnavi.
Am I audible and visible? Okay. So, if opportunities don't knock on your door, you need to search for the door to knock on them. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. My journey to join Toastmaster, though it is a very short process of just messaging Toastmaster Spoorthy, but it felt like a decade-long wait. Due to the pandemic, my exams kept postponing, and so did the idea of joining Toastmasters. Obstacles are opportunities in disguise. Ask those businesses who fell and rose like a star. They are the ones who will tell you how they made worst obstacles become the golden opportunity, which has made them today the global leaders of the market. Our president, who is an aspiring chartered accountant, she is an ento cutlet and loves painting, playing the guitar, practicing yoga. And she wants to be a linguistic person, and she loves learning different languages. Our president has had a long journey as Toastmaster, from being the former secretary, VPM, and associate VPPR and VP education of the club. And today, she is sitting for the first time as the president of McCain Communication Club. An enthusiastic soul, my mentor, with so much pride, I need to state this, who has always called me during the night for analyzing my speeches and helping me to calm my nervous soul before my speech. Please help me introduce, with a thunderous round of applause, our president, Toastmaster Ankita.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Vaishnavi, for that very warm introduction. Thank you very much. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome, dear guests. I see a few guests in the meeting room today. Can I please request them to unmute as I call upon their name and tell me how they got to know about Toastmasters and Mekon Communication Club? Let's start with Sharanya Prasad. Could you please unmute and tell us?
Yes, I got to know about this because of my friend Ujjwal here. So he used to tell so many things, and I thought even I'll join because I want to improve my communication skills.
Thank you, Sharanya, and welcome to our club.
Thank you.
Can we next have Nutan introduce yourself, please?
Yeah, hi. I got to know this Toastmaster through websites and this Mekon communication also. You know, and it's been in Bangalore South, so I also reside nearby. So I thought of registering for this one. So being into a, you know, inside sales, you know, improving the communication skills is very important. So, you know, Toastmaster is the best way, and, you know, the mentors, the trainers, what we have, I heard that, you know, there are a lot of good mentors who teaches you, you know, how to, you know, communicate in a professional way.
Thank you and welcome to our club. I can guarantee you're in the right place. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
A very warm good evening to all of you present here once again. All of us absolutely love surprises, don't we? An unexpected birthday party, a lost friend suddenly dropping by into our home, or even better, our managers at work pleasantly telling us to leave before 6 p.m. But what happens when life chooses to surprise us instead? Are we delighted? Nope, we are far from that. Before I do continue with my address, I would like the Secretary Toastmaster Bhavani to please read out the minutes of the meeting.
Thank you so much, President Toastmaster Ankita. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Here are the minutes of meeting of the 143rd hybrid meeting held on 3rd January 2022 with the theme, After Every Sunset, There's a Sunrise. The business session started at 6:37 p.m. and was chaired by our immediate past president, Toastmaster Sai Snehal Reddy. In the business session, our immediate past vice president education, Toastmaster Ankita, discussed the following points. All the roles for the next meeting are open, and the interested members are to contact the incoming Vice President Education Toastmaster Spoorthy for the same. The TLI, the COTP, is happening on 9th of January 2022, and all the executive committee members are requested to attend the same online. The district is organizing a series of speech analysis workshop. The first session is being conducted on 4th of January 2022, and all the members are requested to attend the same. The district is also organizing a webinar on how to conduct hybrid meetings on 8th of January 2022, and one of the expert speakers is the past president, Toastmaster Sai Snehal Reddy. The regular meeting started at 6:39 p.m. Acting Sergeant at Arms Toastmaster Spoorthy started the meeting with an introduction about the theme and later handed over the charge to the president, Toastmaster Sai Snehal. President Toastmaster Sai Snehal opened the meeting, delivered the presidential address, and introduced the Master of Ceremonies, Toastmaster Sanjana. Master of Ceremonies, Toastmaster Sanjana, spoke on the theme and introduced the installation officer, Toastmaster Vaibhav Gupta, the Division C Director. The installation officer released the power from the existing executive committee and installed the new officers. The new officers were President Toastmaster Ankita, Vice President Education Toastmaster Spoorthy, Vice President Membership Toastmaster Gaurav, Vice President Public Relations Toastmaster Sanjana, Associate Vice President Public Relations Toastmaster Ujjwal, Treasurer Toastmaster Sandeep, Secretary Toastmaster Bhavani, Sergeant at Arms Toastmaster Vaishnavi, Associate Sergeant at Arms Toastmaster Shiva. The incoming President Toastmaster Ankita delivered her address along with the plan for January to June 2022. The quarterly newsletter with the theme Empowering the Best in You was released by the past Vice President Public Relations Toastmaster Gaurav along with the Division C Director Toastmaster Vaibhav and the immediate past President Toastmaster Sai Snehal. Our immediate past President Toastmaster Sai Snehal announced the winners of the term, the month, and handed over the certificates. The winners of the term were Toastmaster of the Term, Distinguished Toastmaster Rudanka, best newcomer Toastmaster Bhavani, best speaker of the term Toastmaster Prakash, best table topic speaker of the term distinguished Toastmaster AK Prabhakara, best evaluator of the term distinguished Toastmaster AK Prabhakara, and Toastmaster Lalanamurthy. The best TAPG of the term Toastmaster Bhavani, best MTG of the term Toastmaster Lalana, maximum role takers TAPG Toastmaster Gaurav, maximum role takers MTG Toastmaster Lalana, and distinguished Toastmaster Rudank. The best Toastmasters of the month were for July Toastmaster Gaurav, August Toastmaster Sridevi, September distinguished Toastmaster Udang, October Toastmaster Bhavani, November Toastmaster Gaurav, December Toastmaster Arundhati, and the president closed the meeting at 8:08 p.m. Thank you, and back to you, Toastmaster Ankita.
Thank you, Bhavani. Are there any changes to the MOM? Okay. I will consider it as passed, and I open meeting number 1144. And like I was saying, life just chose to surprise me. I totally forgot to call out Bhavani 3.sec, the minutes of the meeting. So I'm sorry for that. Well, continuing with my address, I cleared my IPCC exams and I got into Ernst & Young. I was impatiently looking forward to my first day when I realized that my place of work was in World Trade Center, which is about 15 kilometers from my home. I would have to reluctantly spend a huge amount of time traveling to work every single day. There lay the one thing that came out of a wonderfully wrapped gift that life had decided to give me: dismay and regret. Work began, and I would sit flustered with anxiety every single day in the metro, counting the stations back to Southern Circle. I would complain, rant, and even think of moving out to a place closer to my work, which was much against my parents' wishes. This obstacle of distance was truly turning into a disaster, until one day I decided to turn it into an opportunity. Instead of counting stations to Southern Circle, I would now count the number of articles I could read to and fro the metro station. A user-friendly app called Pocket became my co-passenger, as I would read article after article until towards the end of the year, I received an email from Pocket, the Pocket team, stating that I was one of the top readers for that year. I was motivated beyond measure and navigated further into ebooks with fiction and nonfiction. Lost in a land with my favorite characters and their fascinating lives, I vividly remember forgetting to get off at Southern Circle once and took a train back home. Problems in life are truly endless, but what matters is our response to these problems. If our response is negative, pessimistic, and downbeat, these problems take the form of obstacles. But if our response to them is joy, cheer, and optimism, they transform into opportunities. The COVID-19 pandemic left all of us locked up at home for months together in the last year, and it's still continuing. Some of us chose to complain and rant, while some looked at it as an opportunity to learn something new. I was fortunately able to do this after months of sitting idle in the lockdown. I began to actively engage in yoga, gardening, and also pursued a few online courses in psychology. I can't imagine what my life today would look like without these elements. What I want to leave you all with today is an opportunity-driven mindset. If you have never participated in a contest before, use the upcoming contest season as an opportunity to get over your stage fright, your fear of public speaking. Have you taken up a role in the EC this term? Well, use it to learn something about teamwork and collaboration. Let's turn every bothersome opportunity at hand into a glorious opportunity. With that, let me take the pleasure of introducing the master of ceremonies for today. He is a very enthusiastic person, the VP membership of our club. He has completed his BCom graduation from Jain University and currently is working at PricewaterhouseCoopers. He's a passionate photographer and loves to travel and trek. He also has two dogs, and I recently saw an Instagram story where he's tattooed his dog on his arm. He loves to read crime, suspense, and fantasy fiction books. Please put your hands together, give a thunderous round of applause in welcoming the MC for today, Toastmaster Gaurav Badri.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ankita, for that lovely introduction and heartwarming introduction. Very good evening to all your Toastmasters and to all the guests present today. Obstacles to opportunities. When I listen to this theme, one story that comes to my mind, which I had heard during my school days. Once upon a time, there was a wealthy king. He wanted to test his fellow subjects as to see how smart are they. So one night, he planned to keep a stone in middle of the road, which goes directly towards the court of the kingdom. Early in the morning, when the king's council was about to start, few of his fellow court members came into the council first, and then came the subjects whose problems to be solved. Surprisingly, none of them were even tried to even move the stone from the middle of the road. So this kept the king worried as to what to do next. But then there was a potter who was amazing artist, and he was known for his beautiful statues that he has created. He had made a beautiful statue of the king, and he was on the way to go to the council to show it to the king. When he was about to enter the council, he saw a stone in middle of the road, and he tried so many times to pick it up, but he was not able to. But at the end, after several attempts, he was able to move the stone aside. After moving the stone, he sees that there is a small bag which was under the stone. He picks up the bag and he goes to the king along with the statue, and he tells, "I found this bag on the middle of the road." The king said, "Can you please open the bag?" Once he opened, he saw that there was a lot of gold coins stuffed inside the bag. And the king said, "Keep this as a reward for moving the stone aside." In this story, which seemed to be an obstacle and a problem to many of them, turned out to be an opportunity to the potter. The same way in our lives, it is left to us as to how to face our obstacles and turn out to be an opportunity. Even when it comes to our own club in Toastmasters, in last term when we started the hybrid meeting, we had a lot of obstacles. At start, there used to be a bandwidth issue, an internet problem, or there used to be a mic issue. But still, it never stopped us from coming out of all these obstacles and took it as an opportunity to conduct the wonderful hybrid meetings in the last term. Now, when it comes to opportunities, I would like to talk about a person by name Raj C. Smedley, who didn't miss out an opportunity to start this wonderful platform called Toastmasters in the year 1924 at Santa Ana, California. He started this Toastmasters with the belief that it will help a lot of members to come out of their public speaking fear and improve their communication and leadership skills. Today, Toastmasters membership exceeds more than 356,000 across 145 countries, serving through 16,800 member clubs. A typical Toastmasters meeting consists of three sessions. The first session is the prepared speech session, where the speaker delivers his or her speech based on the project guidelines. The second session is the table topic session, where the table topic master will choose a random person from the audience and will give an impromptu topic, and that person should talk for 1 or 2 minutes. Third session is the general evaluation session, where the general evaluator will evaluate the proceedings of the meeting and give his valuable feedback. Now, before we proceed to the first session, I would like to call the role takers for today, who is known as the TAPG team, and they are like the four pillars who help us with the smooth functioning of today's meeting. As I call out the role takers, I request the role takers to please explain your roles. First is Toastmaster Ujjwal, who is playing dual role, that is timer and car counter. I would like to ask Ujjwal to please explain both the roles.
A very happy evening to all the fellow Toastmasters. As time plays a very important role in each and everyone's life, it's our responsibility to stick into the time allotted for us. So as a timer, I'll be noting down the time taken by each speaker. In case of prepared speech session, I'll be showing the green card at 5 minutes, yellow card at 6 minutes, and green card, and red card for 7 minutes. For the table topic session, I'll be showing the green card at 1 minute, yellow card at 1 minute 30 seconds, and the red card at 2 minutes. Then lastly, for the evaluation session, I'll be showing the green card at 2 minutes, yellow card at 2 minutes 30 seconds, and the red card at 3 minutes. I'll give my evaluation at the general evaluation session. Now moving on to the R counters introduction. The purpose of an R counter is to note any overused words or filler sounds used as such by anyone who speaks during the meeting. Words may be inappropriate interjections such as and, well, but, so, and you know. Sounds may be or er. I'll give my report at the general evaluation session. Thank you, and over to Master of Ceremonies.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ujjwal. Can we give him a huge round of applause? Next, I'd like to call the grammarian Toastmaster Sanjana.
Am I audible?
Yeah, you're audible.
Grammar is the breathing power for the life of language. A very good evening to fellow Toastmasters and esteemed guests. As the grammarian of today's session, I'll be closely listening to all your speeches and making a note of the good usages as well as the not so good usages. The word of the week is gullible. The meaning of the word is easily persuaded to believe something. Usage, an attempt to persuade a gullible public to spend their money. I'd request everyone to use the same. I'd submit my report at the end of the session. Back to you, MC.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sanjana. Now I'd like to call Parliamentary Procedure Evaluator, Toastmaster Varaprasad. So you're not audible.
Sorry, muted, speaking with a muted. Hi, good evening all. Good evening Toastmasters and dear guests. It's important to have boundaries to any meeting to make sure we have a very good meeting going on and have a motivation and inspiring us even in the meeting and also end of the meeting. As a PP evaluation, I request all of you to keep your the video on throughout as much as possible, unless bandwidth limits it, and keep yourself muted unless you are required to speak. In case of leaving the meeting, make sure you leave the message and also try to leave maybe in the end of a speech or before beginning instead of in between. And also important, please avoid talking about sex, religion, or politics in any of your speeches or any of the talk. And I'll update the report back in the end of the session. Thank you. Back to MC.
Thank you, Toastmaster Varaprasad. Can you give all the roll takers a round of applause? Now let's start with the first session, that is prepared speech session. And the first speaker for today is attempting level 3 project 1. And I request the individual evaluator, Toastmaster Sandeep, to read out the project guidelines.
Good evening, everyone. This is a level 3 project from Inspire Your Audience Manual. The purpose of this speech is, the purpose of this project is for the member to practice writing and delivering a speech that inspires others. The purpose of the speech is for the member to inspire the audience. The time limit is 5 to 7 minutes. Good luck to the evaluator. Back to you, MC.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sandeep. The first speaker for today, as overall having more than 26 years of work experience in banking and microfinance sector, presently working as Vice President in IIFL Semester Microfinance. Few of his hobbies include reading self-development books, playing chess, swimming, and trekking. He is a Triple Crown awardee and a Pathkeepers awardee. With a huge round of applause, help me welcome the first speaker for today, Toastmaster Prakash, with his speech titled, Be a Warrior, Not a Worrier.
99% of the things you worry about don't even happen. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guest. How many of you agree with me? Wonderful. I can see majority of you are strongly agreeing with me. Let me share my experience. During my school and college days, I used to spend a lot of time in the city central library reading various newspapers and weekly or monthly periodicals. One fine day, I came across Competition Success Review monthly magazine. On reading the editorial page, I got inspired and started preparing for various competitive exams. During my final year degree, I was able to crack the banking examination and appeared for the interview. Fellow Toastmasters, that was the first time I appeared for the interview. In the panel, there were 10 senior banking professionals. When they started asking questions, I felt very nervous and was not able to answer the questions which I knew very well. The main reason was, on the day of the interview, I had already started worrying whether I'll be selected or not, and had lost my confidence. And finally, I was not able to clear the interview. But next year, I was able to overcome the worries, and post completion of my graduation, I was able to clear both the exams and interviews successfully. In Mecca Communication Club, when I delivered my first icebreaker speech, once again, I got the same feeling. But later on, when I started taking up the various roles and started delivering speeches, I adopted 5-4-3-2-1 exercise. This exercise made my worry factor evaporate like a bubble. So, fellow Toastmasters, do you all want to know what is this 5-4-3-2-1 exercise? Great. So let me start. Before starting this exercise, pay attention to your breathing. Slow, deep, long breaths can help you maintain a sense of calm or help you return to the calmer state. But don't stop breathing. I said, please pay attention. Once you find your breath, go through the following steps to help you to ground yourself. Five, acknowledge five things you see around you. It could be a pen, a spot on the ceiling, anything in your surroundings. Four, acknowledge four things you can touch around you. It could be your air, a pillow, or the ground under your feet. Three, acknowledge three things you hear. This could be any external sound. Even if you hear your belly rumbling, that also counts. Focus on the things you can hear outside of your body. Acknowledge two things you can smell. Maybe you are in your office and smell a pencil. Or maybe you are in a bedroom and smell a pillow. If you need to take a brief walk to find the scent you could smell, maybe soap in your bathroom or nature outside. Number one, acknowledge one thing you can taste. What does the inside of your mouth taste like? A gum, coffee, or the sandwich from the lunch? Whatever it might be. Fellow Toastmasters, if you adopt this exercise, I can give you all 100% guarantee that you'll be able to overcome any worries during any moment of the day. Please don't feel that I am making an attempt to make you all gullible. every week our VP education is finding very difficult to find the role takers. Many of you might not having the confidence or worrying what will happen if you take up the role. As Dale Carney has quoted, stop worrying about what can go wrong and get excited about what can go right. How you will be able to improve your communication and leadership skills and start living. Fellow Toastmasters, please wake up, think big, never quit, worry less and stay strong. Over to the MC of the day, Toastmaster Gaurav.
Thank you, Toastmaster Prakash, for that. It was an amazing speech. Can we give him a huge round of applause? Now, coming to the second speaker, he's attempting level 4 project 1. And I request the individual evaluator, Toastmaster Bhavani, to read out the project guidelines.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Gaurav. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. The speaker is attempting from the pathway presentation mastery. The purpose of this project is for the member to practice the skills needed to address audience challenges when he or she presents outside of the Toastmasters. The length of the speech is 10 to 15 minutes. All the best to the speaker and back to you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Gaurav.
Thank you, Toastmaster Bhavani. The second speaker is currently pursuing his engineering in City Engineering College as computer science as his background. He is a passionate photographer and aspires to become a wildlife photographer one day. He is a Triple Crown winner and the youngest distinguished Toastmaster through Pathways in India. With a huge round of applause, help me welcome the second speaker for today, distinguished Toastmaster Rudanka, with a speech titled Tears of the Moon.
Thank you, Toastmaster Gaurav. Timer, you can start my timing now. Way back in time, there was a tribe in dense Amazon forest. As you all know, there is nothing in and around Amazon forest for the tribes to do at the evening. So they used to set up a campfire, circle around it, singing, dancing, and many more activities to kill the time. One such evening, while they're enjoying the campfire, a loud noise, a big tear came rushing the atmosphere of the earth, crashing on the ground. Having a bright pink light, making the darkness turn into a bright pink day, and it formed a pink tree. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome, my dear guests. Let's keep this tribe people aside for a while. On the banks of the river Amazon, there were many kingdoms. And in such one of such kingdoms, there lived a king happily with his wife and his princess and a soldier whom he treated as just as his younger brother. They lived happily, enjoying the moments, did not worry about anything, did not have the rivalries between the other kingdoms. It was a happy-going kingdom. One day, there came a situation where the entire happiness came to an end. What was the situation? Why does happiness come to an end? The lovely princess fell sick with a disease which could not be cured. Many of the saints, pandits, tried their level best to save the life of the little prince, but failed to do so. King gave the best of the best medicine to save. He brought best of the medicines across the globe, but it neither did not work out.
Udang, what kind of a disease was it though?
As per the story, what we can guess, it was an ancient time and there was no proper doctors to cure it, but to see from the outer range if that disease is not curable, probably it must she must be have diagnosed with cancer.
Okay.
Once, while this king and the other soldiers and were deeply thinking what to do about the situation, there came an old man seeing the king to get the pink petal from the dense Amazon forest. Now you all must have got the connection, right? Where this story of this king is leading to. As soon as he hears this, the king, without having a second thought, rushes to the forest along with the soldiers and the main soldier whom he treated as his younger brother. In the midst of Amazon, deep Amazon forest, in middle of anacondas, pythons, and unknown creatures, with all the injuries, with all the scratches in their body, with all the tiredness, they manage to reach a group of tribe. A tribe was so generous enough that they offered them a helping hand in curing them. Even these guys needed a shelter, needed some rest. After so long journey in tough routes, they were really not in a position to continue forward. They agreed with the tribe. They accepted the tribe's offers and settled down in that little area. While they were treating, the eldest tribe member came with this coconut shell and inside it a pink liquid. As soon as the pink liquid was given to the soldiers and the kings, the wounds, the scratches were all disappeared in a jiffy. The tiredness, what they had, was all over. They was with full enthusiasm. The energy level was unmatchable. They were fully grown, glowing, just like a energetic or a, what you can say, a six-pack bodybuilder. They were so much glowing and full of energy. After the situation raised, which made the entire pink tree to submerge deep inside the river. What was that situation? Why did the tree go deep inside the river? Hold on your thoughts for a while. Now let us come back. Let us come forward in time and see what is happening in at present or a few years ago. As I told, let's come forward in time, many centuries passed. One of the archaeologists in London found out this history of the pink tree, found out the hidden truth of this. She was curious enough to know what exactly and how this pink tree was to look. So she started her journey in the same routes in the what king took. For that, she had to reach.
How did the archaeologist find out about the pink tree? Because you haven't mentioned anything about that.
Sai, that's the suspense of the story. Please hold on.
Okay.
Now, to follow that path, she has to go to the rivers of the Amazon. She reached the banks of the Amazon River and happened to meet, and she took a cruise to go half the way in the river because, excuse me, as I told, the tree was deeply submerged in the river. While she met the captain of the ship or the cruise, she felt strange. He was a strange man. A man who had no family, a man who never known to the outer world, a man who was nothing to others. He was full of debuts, full of energy, and to scare people around him, he had leopards and cheetahs as his pets. Seeing this, not only the archaeologist, anyone can frighten out. The same thing happened to the archaeologist. She took a step back and decided not to continue her journey. But the motivation or the destiny what she had planned was a big destiny. She was not pretty sure, but she had an idea. If she could find that pink tree, it would change the entire mankind. So she bravely started the journey with this weird man. It was not only the archaeologist who came with her. There was few maps with her which made her go in the same way the king had been a years ago. This map on the record says it was written by one of the soldiers who was present with the king. Sai, I think you must got the answer now. She found out the maps of the maps where it leaded. After going half the way, she was stopped by few local people saying, there is nothing such kind. This all are bullshit. Please go back. She did not consider that. She went one more step forward. Another day passed. A few tribe people stopped her, saying, this is not the place where common people should come. Please go back. Nah, it did not stop her neither. She continued her journey. And there was another set of tribe people who were very evil. And they attacked them. Then they captured this captain and the archaeologist. But while the captain and the tribe were arguing, she figured it out. All this blockage, what she had in her journey, was all created by that captain. She got so angry, so she rushed near the captain to ask why he did. And at the heat of the moment, they started arguing. In the same heat of the moment, she threw a stone that resulted in getting a sharp arrow right into the chest of the captain, and the captain fell a cliff down. Seeing this accident or the tragedy, she was fully upset. She was fully...
Udanka, so you said that the captain had created all the problems for her. If he had pets as leopards, then he could have just unleashed those pets on her.
Yes, initially he tried doing it, but when she entered the boat, she got used to it because that journey was not a day or hour journey. It was a weeks together journey. So she was used to play around with those pets. After this, all this sort of thing, she, the next day, started the journey alone. After moving a day, she found someone yelling in the banks of the river. She immediately went to rescue him. Surprisingly, that was the captain. The man who had got stung by a knife at his chest and who had fallen a cliff down was alive. She was in exact same state how you all know. Confused state. What exactly happened? Do you all recall I saying this captain as a weird man? Yes, this weird man was nothing or no one other than the soldier whom the king treated as his younger brother. And it is the same soldier who wrote the map which archaeologists got it. While, let me explain, now you must be wondering, now you must have got some links to this story. Only thing what I have not revealed is how did that pink tree get submerged. To explain you how that pink tree got submerged, while the king got that medicine, he was extremely happy. He thought his daughter would be cured in a minute. And he came to greediness. Coming to greediness, he attacked the tribe and with the help of the soldiers. But this soldier, the captain, stopped him, but failed to, because it was one against an army. Luckily, that petal had some verse which had to be chanted before it turned into a medicine. So, listening to this, he got more anger and killed all the tribes. before he killed the last or the eldest tribe, the eldest tribe cursed everyone around him, saying, these members will be immortal and it will be, they should never leave the bank of the river. As this soldier or the captain helped him a bit to rescue, he was not, he did not get anything. But other kings and the soldiers were home to many earthworms, cockroaches, and many other insects buried alive inside the earth or the banks of the river. Now, the captain and the archaeologist, knowing the past, reached the place. As soon as the captain reaches, all the kings, along with his soldiers, attack them from nowhere so that to get that pink petal for them to get released from the curse. While there was a fight between the captain, soldier, and the king, they set up the pink tree on fire. And none, neither the king, neither the captain, neither any of the soldiers could get the petal. But the archaeologist somehow managed to get the last petal of the pink tree alive without getting burnt a bit also. That petal was given to the soldier captain, which made him a normal person, releasing all the curses on him. He could leave the bank of the river and he could feel the wounds on his body. He could have some disease on him. He could feel exactly how he felt years, centuries ago. Now, what did exactly happen in this story? What did you guys learn? The king, he had everything around him. He had the bright future. He could have saved his life, his daughter's life, and everybody's life. But he came to a greediness and destroyed his own life, others' life, and did not only destroy the lives around him, but also destroyed the beautiful gem which was given from the Mother Nature to help the mankind. Back to Master of Ceremony. Over to you, Toastmaster Gaurav.
Thank you, distinguished Toastmaster Rudanka, for narrating such a fantastic story. Can we give him a huge round of applause? Now, it comes to the end of the first session. So let's start with the second session for today. The second session is the table topic session. And I'd like to introduce the table topic master for today. He is a BCom graduate from Jain College, currently pursuing his US CPA along with MCom, and is passionate about table tennis, geography, and Indian history. With a huge round of applause, help me welcome the table topic master for today, Toastmaster Shiva.
Thank you for that introduction, Toastmaster Gaurav. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. We have now entered the table topic session, which according to me is the most exciting and interesting session of part of our meeting. So for the benefit of the guests, let me explain what happens in our table topic sessions. I will pick up topics and give it randomly to any of our members or guests, and they will have to speak on it for about 1 or 2 minutes. So basically, table topic session helps you build your impromptu speaking skills. You can speak without preparation, which can be a very vital skill in the real world. And okay, let's get started with the session. Let me share my screen. Is my screen visible?
Yeah.
Yes.
So the theme for today is obstacles to opportunities. And I expect all of you to treat my table topics as obstacles and convert them into opportunities to speak for yourself, speak and express yourself. So the first topic for today, don't major in minor things. And I'd like to give this topic to DTM AK Prabhakar. Don't major in minor things.
Mr. Table Topic Master, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guests. Don't major in minor things. I feel this is not right. Let me explain that. It is the minor change at micro level that makes the huge change at macro level. So the minor things are important. And this can be explained by several examples from science. For example, the first ever attempt at cloning was tried at University of Edinburgh in Scotland. And Wilmot and Keith Campbell, they were the pioneers. In fact, they drew a cell from the udder of a sheep and made another sheep out of it. They call it Dolly the sheep. Can you call that minor thing as you should not major in that? Even Crick and Watson, who really deciphered there is a double helix formation as far as DNA is concerned. And it was a very minor thing if you look at it, but it made a huge impact. Today, COVID vaccination is prepared and synthesized within 42 days. It used to take years to make a vaccine earlier. You take one century ago. Today, it is because of Crick and Watson, minor things like that, that such a huge impact is there. In fact, the devil is in the detail, there's a saying. So detail is a very minor stuff. And without that life has not moved. In fact, the fire detection, the discovery of fire by once upon a time, thousands of years ago by somebody. And he just rubbed the stone and saw the spark. And then he started blowing air into it and he got the fire. And first time, artificially, the fire was discovered. It was a very minor thing. Today we have electricity from which you can create fire. So the minor thing, you should major it. I don't agree with this topic. Over to Table Topic Master.
Thank you for that brilliant response, DTM AK Prabhakar, and I will keep that in mind. Okay, so the next topic for today. Yes. Anger results in increased productivity. I would like to give this topic to Toastmaster Sai Snehal. Anger results in increased productivity.
Thank you, Table Topic Master. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Anger results in increased productivity. During one of the earlier days when I was supposed to prepare for one of the president's speech, the theme chosen by the MC was rather a little tricky. And I hadn't prepared anything as such till the 3 p.m. on the same evening. So I sat down and I was actually getting very furious because I was not able to put my mind into thought and get a positive speech on it. I was getting really angry. I was not able to do anything. That's when I realized I was trying to get so angry on the situation rather than trying to solve it. But that anger helped me in a way, or rather pushed me into a sense of productivity and urgency, which made me finish an entire speech in 1 hour. That is when I realized that anger is not just something that you show at a situation and do nothing about it. Sometimes you can use it to be productive about yourself. Long back when we realized that COVID was all about lockdown and we couldn't really go out anywhere, a lot of us just stayed at home and did nothing. But there are some people who just got very angry about it and went on to create startups which became unicorns and everything because they were angry about the fact that they couldn't do anything and ended up doing something because of the state they were in. That is what anger does to you. The next time you're angry, try to use it in a productive sense so that you can get something out of it rather than just showing it out or venting it out to somebody and gaining nothing out of it. This way you will be in a better place. Although anger is not a very good emotion to display, it is rather better to use it in a productive than vent it out somewhere. Thank you, and back to the table topic, Master.
Thank you for that brilliant response, I must say, from Toastmaster Sai Snail. Moving on to the next topic. You can't wait for inspiration. You have to go after it. I repeat, you can't wait for inspiration. You have to go after it. And I'd like to give this topic to Toastmaster Vijay Upendra.
Thank you, Table Topic Master. Good evening, Toastmasters. Welcome, guests. You can't wait for inspiration. You have to go after it. I would like to slightly deviate from the statement. Inspiration is internal. Motivation is external. Unless you have some motivation, how will you get the inspiration from one's own within? Is a major question. We all have seen people waiting for some small motivation, a spark, so that they start their work and they never stop till they reach the goal. What I mean by that? The inner capability of an independent individual need to be understood through inspiration. The external motivation adds to it, and thereby we are able to finish whatever task that we have undertaken. In that way, understanding our own inner capabilities, which are hidden in positive emotions, through introspection, one need to evaluate one's own self so that a small spark as a motivation from the external world helps to go ahead. We have seen a lot of advertisements, which is from the external source. You go and buy without even thinking about emotionally what is it's required or not. So that is the area where we need to train ourselves to understand the motivation as well as the inspiration properly, so that we can take a decision and move on in life to reach and achieve our goals. Thank you, and back to you, Table Topic Master of the Day.
That was a great response, Toastmaster Vijay Upendra. Moving on to the next topic. Yes, listen twice as much as you talk. I'd like to give this topic to Toastmaster Varaprasad. Listen twice as much as you talk.
Table Topic Masters, fellow Toastmasters, dear guest. Listening is an art, everybody says. And you might have heard, or we keep hearing, that listening is an important skill in all areas. I was always wondering what stops us listening. And this is one of the topic always I'm focused, because I'm repeatedly getting to hear that my listening skills also need to be further improved. Listening is something which is connected to the interest. If you are interested on the subject, on the topic, what drives you to that? So interest and the motive and the drive which you have towards subject or a topic or a discussion enables you to listen. Sometimes we often go out of it or keep switching. Especially we believe that we can do multitasking, and then many times we ended up not productive either of that. For me, it really helped when I started looking at why I'm not interested in that topic, why I'm not able to focus and listen. And once I started looking at detailing of it, then finding reasons why I'm not interested in this topic, that really, really made me to find out the possible options me to work out to build interest in the topic. Because when I say I'm not interested, then I have to attach an importance to it. Is it really important for me professionally, personally, or why I am into this discussion? See, look at it. The listening is connected to the interest. Interest is connected to the importance, and importance connected to how you get yourself connected to it with professional or personal or your goal or connect. So it's always said, naturally we start listening, but listening definition says that how much you understood, how much you focused. So my suggestion to all is listen twice or listen more than twice for any topic before you go react. Instead, see whether you can listen more, understand, and be sure before you react to the topic. Thank you. Back to Shiva, Toastmaster of the day, Table Topic Master of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Varaprasad, for that information-filled response. Okay. Moving on to the next topic. Yes. Being able to cook can increase your lifespan. I would like to give this topic to Toastmaster Sanjana. Being able to cook can increase your lifespan.
Once again, very good evening to fellow Toastmasters and esteemed guests. I never knew the hack for long life was to be able to cook. And thank you for such a wonderful hack. So this is the first time I'm listening to something like this. And surely, I think I'm going to work on my cooking skills just for, a long life. maybe because of knowing the ingredients of what you put in your vessel, you will be more conscious of making an effort of putting ingredients of nutritious values. Maybe that would contribute to a healthy lifestyle, which would in turn result in a long life. You would be very conscious in your eating. You will be very conscious in your eating because you know the amount of oil you must have used, and excess amount of oil is definitely not good for your body. So I think that is my take on being able to cook can increase your lifespan. Thank you, and back to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sanjana, and that was a very good response. Moving on to the next topic. Yes, okay. Reality TV shows have lost touch with reality. I would like to give this topic to Toastmaster Rashmi. Reality TV shows have lost touch with reality.
Am I audible and visible? My topic is reality shows have lost touch with reality. We see so many reality shows going on TV. Actually, I don't watch TV only. My daughters will not allow me to watch the TV all the time. They were watching YouTube videos. Reality shows like Saregamapa, they have lots of drama. I have seen many dramas are going on. All are very dramatic. They'll cry. They will laugh. They don't actually relate what is happening in reality. When in our college, we were discussing some of the contestant in Saregamapa or some, I don't remember the name of the reality show. He was actually sitting in some hotel and begging for the money. And they simply show on TV that they are like heroes. They always want to be in limelight. It doesn't any relation with the reality. They want to take the attention. They are the attention seekers. They want to be always on the limelight. It doesn't have any actually the real life is different from the reality show. That is my take on this topic. Thank you. Back to table topic master.
Yes, thank you for that wonderful response, Toastmaster Rashmi. Moving on to the next topic. Okay. Masks will become a fashion accessory in the future. And I'd like to give this topic to Toastmaster Vaishnavi.
Hello. Am I audible, Shiva?
Yes, you're audible.
Okay. So my topic is masks will become a fashion accessory in the future. Well, I don't think it's already, we are already in the future right now. You can find, I had gone shopping last week and I found these matching kurtas with matching masks. And I was like, okay, this has already been in the, it's already been in the process. And because the pandemic will stay for more than 2-3 years, maybe soon in Lakme Fashion Week, we won't have the dresses on board for showcase. We will have masks. So yes, masks has already become a fashion accessory now. And no doubt in the future, we will have amazing masks like you just have put in your picture. New creative ways to advertise products. So yeah, that's my take on the topic. Table topic master.
Thank you for that response, Toastmaster Vaishnavi. And next topic. If you aren't willing to look like a foolish beginner, you'll never become a graceful master. I'd like to give this topic to Toastmaster Sandeep. If you aren't willing to look like a foolish beginner, you'll never become a graceful master.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, table topic master Shiva. The topic is, if you are not willing to look like a foolish beginner, you will never become a graceful master. I think the one thing which comes to my mind, which I can relate to the topic, is the best way to learn something is to educate someone. For example, if you want to learn some aspect of public speaking or any complicated subject, first try to make someone understand who do not have or who have very little knowledge of the subject. So you will understand the difficulty while explaining, and you will try to explain it in a simpler manner so that the listener will understand the subject. in that process, I think you learn a lot. It has already happened with me many times. Recently, I have been assigned with one colleague who has joined. So many times when I try to explain her something, in that process, I realize I have not learned or I have not seen that aspect of that subject previously. So the topic is very much relatable. I think if you do not feel like, if you cease to feel like you are a expert, then you cease to learn something new the very moment. So it is always advisable to be open and to be willing to learn something as a beginner. Maybe on a long run, you will become a graceful master. So that is take on my topic. Back to you, Toastmaster Siva.
Yes, that was a very good take on the topic, Toastmaster Sandeep. Moving on to the next topic. Yes. Overthinking ultimately leads to regret. And I'd like to give this topic to Toastmaster Krishnamurthy. Overthinking ultimately leads to regret.
Thank you, Shiva Prasad. I never expecting an IT topic for a GE, but however, I would try to respond it. Overthinking ultimately leads to regret. It's not always. I would say sometimes we need to seriously think on certain topics when we are encountering such a situation. So we need to definitely think on it, whether over or underthinking, it does not matter. But thinking has to be done. We all do that, you know, 24/7, even in our dreams, we keep thinking on so many things, you know, knowingly or unknowingly. So thinking is a part and parcel of a human being. So we definitely, but overthinking, I do not understand unless you stress yourself. But if you don't stress yourself and if you keep thinking, that's how many inventions have happened. You know, they had not put their effort and they would have definitely not achieved, you know, Thomas Alva Edison would have not found the light what we have today. And like that, so many inventions would have not happened. They are all the people who have done definitely much more overthinking than what we common human beings does. So the scientists definitely go overboard and they do overthinking, and that's how they have also made a lot of good results, which we can see. You know. So I think overthinking ultimately leads to regret is not a right proposition. It depends on the situation and how one thinks on it. Back to you, table topic.
Yes, that was a very good take on the topic. Thank you, Toastmaster Krishnamurthy. And moving on to the next topic. Yeah, don't lend money to your friends. You might lose both. I want to give this topic to Toastmaster Arun Das. Don't lend money to your friends. You might lose both.
Fellow Toastmasters and Table Topic Master, thank you for this opportunity. So today's session has been very interesting for me also. This don't lend money to your friends, you might lose both. I would agree to this topic, and I find it a little difficult also as I'm, you know, friends, you know, ask for money. It's not about the, you know, aspect of money. I always, you know, whomever asked me, I always, you know, been there as a helping hand. You know, I simply follow one rule, you know, whomever asks for money, if they don't return it next time, I don't lend them money. That's what I do. And it practically, yes. See, somebody who lends money, you know, if that is within your friend circle, you might find it a little difficult to, you know, ask them to return the money. So that is one challenge. I haven't lost much, but yeah, of course, you know, I'm not, I would say money is, you know, something apart, but In terms of friendship, I've not lost any friends while lending money to anybody. But of course, the relationship and friendships are precious. It's precious than money. I would strongly agree to that point. But obviously, it's difficult to handle the situation. This topic is also interesting, but that situation is a little difficult to handle. When your friend come and ask you for help, at that point of time, definitely you can't. If it is a genuine reason, some medical reason, obviously we may have to extend our help. But we should be a little wise. Based on the situation, we need to take a call. That's all. Thank you. Back to the table topic, Master.
I think that was a great response, Toastmaster Arun Das. Moving on to the next topic. Okay. So this topic is a bit off topic, but I'd like to give this to Toastmaster Bhavani. How would you convince Virat Kohli to shave off his beard?
Thank you so much, Table Topic Master Toastmaster Shiva. I think this would be the most difficult table topic I would have ever answered because I love him and love him with the beard. So challenging myself to talk against that. So this is a conversation of me with him. So, hi Virat, I am a very, very huge fan of you. Ever since I saw you on the flat TV screen playing for RCB, the four word slogan Isara Kapnam De always stayed on the tip of my tongue. Irrespective of you winning or losing, I'd always be your fan. And whenever you are with the men in blue representing India, we always cheer for you, and I will always be in front of the TV compared to my other cousins or the family members. And you have always been my phone wallpaper from my first telephone, the mobile gadget which I have got. And I have so many cutouts of you in the scrapbook, in my room and everywhere, irrespective of my parents scolding me not to have the pictures of men in the room. So with all this telling you how huge fan I am, I have only a very small request. I want to see you without your beard, at least for once. If you don't want to do it for me, it's okay. I will ask Anushka to request you for the same. Do it at least for her. If you don't want to do that also, it's okay. I will give you one brand which says or which endorses you, telling that you look good without the beard also. But as a huge, huge fan, irrespective of you not being or playing in RCB again, I and my friends will always support you. So at least for that, this is my humble request, and back you, Toastmaster Shiva, for this difficult topic.
That was a great response, Toastmaster Bhavani. And I'll give the last topic for the day. And I want any of the guests to take this one up. Nutan or Sharanya Prasad, any of you? Okay, I guess they are not there. So I'd like to end the table topic session here. And I hope you all enjoyed the session. Back to the Master of Ceremonies, Toastmaster Gaurav.
Thank you, Toastmaster Shiva, for that wonderful and a fun table topic session. And I give him a huge round of applause because it's the first time that he's doing the table topic master role. So looking forward for you taking up further roles in the meeting. Now, let us have a 5-minute break. So the time is 7:40. So we'll get back at 7:45. I think we can proceed with the meeting. Okay, let me start off with the third session for today, which is a general evaluation session. And I'd like to call the general evaluator for today. A general evaluator has completed his BTech in civil from NITK Suratkal in 1983. He has over 32 years of experience in the field of civil engineering and construction activities. He is the chartered president of NITK BI Toastmasters Club and also Rotary Fellowship of Toastmasters. With a huge round of applause, please help me welcome the general evaluator for today, Toastmaster Krishnamurthy. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Gaurav, for that nice introduction. Thank you very much. In this general evaluation, Toastmasters receive feedback which will benefit all the Toastmasters and how they have done and how they can improve, you know, these kind of things. And overall, I'll give the general evaluation on the overall meeting, how it went down well, how it can be improved. This is the basic objective of the general evaluator. The meeting started at 6:23 p.m. It should have started around 6:15. So 8 minutes is absolutely okay. You know, in this corona pandemic time, 8 minutes is nothing. So I felt it is absolutely okay. And President Ankita conducted the business session very nicely. She talked about club officers training and contest workshops which are all going on, and requested other Toastmasters to join that, and the judges training, so on and so forth. It was very nicely conducted, and that was very nice from you, Ankita. And Sergeant at Arms Toastmaster Vaishnavi Harish, she started off the meeting very nicely. And she has an excellent voice and vocabulary as well. And she was quite energetic. But only thing what I saw missing was, you know, her contact to the camera. If she can improve that, and I think that she's going to be a very good Toastmaster. So please start looking at the camera. I'm sure you will get that. That is the only suggestion I have. Otherwise, you have done an excellent job. I think she deserves a round of applause from all of us for that energetic opening of the meeting. And she also did the introduction of the president very well. I think that was also, I noticed, that was very nice of you. And coming to the president address, President Toastmaster Ankita opened the meeting, followed by guest introduction, and also the secretary's report was read out by Toastmaster Bhavani. And very meticulously she read out. But only one suggestion when she's reading out, she can look at the camera once in a while, you know, like how the newsreaders does. They are also reading out, but at the same time, they look once in a while the audience. So I think that will improve, gives a little more meaningful report, I would say. So you can practice that. I'm sure you can do it. You have excellent, again, you know, vocabulary and communication skills. You read out very nicely. Thank you for that, Bhavani. And coming to Ankita again, you know, she gave a nice example on the theme that she was commuting about 15 kilometers. And, you know, it was a problem, obstacle, I would say, she thought initially. But then once she started using it as a, you know, opportunity, so she started using the time of commuting into, you know, reading some articles and so many other purposes. She felt it was never an obstacle. So the very nice example she gave. And also, you know, during COVID time also, she gave another example, how she did yoga, gardening, and online classes of psychology. So that's how most people have done it. So it is for us to make use of the obstacles as an opportunity. Simply sitting, you know, obstacles are there, we can't do anything, you know, nothing can be done in this world. So that was very nice. And her introduction of the MC was very good with all the relevant details. Can we have a huge round of applause to the president for that first debut meeting she has done it. Thank you, Ankita, for that. We'll now have the evaluations. The first speaker was Toastmaster Prakash. Now I will request individual evaluator Sandeep, whether you are given the evaluation notes and the project guidelines by the VPE.
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So that means the systems are on place. That is the way it should be done. So what do you know, Sandeep? You can go ahead with the evaluation.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. Good evening, General Evaluator and Toastmaster Prakash. The topic of the speech was Be a Warrior, Not a Warrior. It's a fantastic wordplay and a nice title to the speech. I will divide my evaluation into two parts. Part one is accomplished and excelled, wherein 99% of things what happened in the speech, good things. And part two, which rest 1%, which can make the speech very can take it to the next level, like exemplary speech. In the part one, the things which the speaker could accomplish are creating a vivid imagery of the scene, like City Central Library or a interview scene, which most of us can relate to. The preparation of speech, I think in terms of delivery and in terms of structure, the speaker had prepared the speech very sincerely. The presentation of speech was in very enthusiastic and inspiring manner. The body language was used to maintain the audience connection. The speaker used his personal anecdotes, which immediately connected with me and was very much relatable, like most of us get scared in interview scenes. And he had a fantastic quote to end: stop worrying what can go wrong, but get excited about what can go right. And the 1% of things which I would suggest to the speaker is, of course, that 5-4-3-2-1 technique was adopted, and the speaker himself, of being 20 years of experience in finance industry and heading a company, has implemented that. So it must be very effective and must be very authentic. To add on to the authenticity, if the speaker could have given the science behind 5-4-3-2-1 principle, like if it has been suggested by some scientific organization or a psychological organization, which he can give more reinforcement to his belief and what he has done. And today I felt somewhere the humorous side of the speaker was missing. I think it was necessary in this serious speeches. I think Inspire Your Audience was earlier CC10 of the Competent Communication Manual, which used to be landmark speech. And today the speaker have given his landmark speech perhaps. And this is what, to summarize, the speaker has accomplished and excelled in 99% of the speech. And the only 1%, I'm sure he is going to take care to make the speech exemplary. Back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sandeep Kumar. That was an excellent evaluation you have done. And you also gave very good suggestion. I was also wondering that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, on what basis it is going to help. I think had he given, as you rightly suggested, a scientific thing, it would have been more meaningful in agreeing to whatever he has suggested. And as you said, generally he creates a lot of humor, and that was missing. Both the points were very good suggestions to him. And another thing what I noticed, which of course I'm not supposed to be commenting on the speaker as such, but he was going to the computer and coming back. I don't know why that was required. So probably if you can avoid and continuously give your speech, it would be more, it will be well taken by the audience. It would look nice also, rather than going near to computer and coming back. So that can be avoided. So I think that was an excellent evaluation, Sandeep Kumar. I think the speaker, Prakash, as well as Sandeep Kumar, deserves a round of applause from all of us. Thank you. Now we'll move on to the second speaker, DTM Udanka. which is giving level 2 project 1, I suppose. Over to you, Toastmaster Bhavani Heman.
Thank you so much, Gender Evaluator Toastmaster Krishnamurti.
And before you start, I hope you also must have received your evaluation notes. And
yes. Firstly, I confirmed that the VP Education handles the same before. So thank you so much, General Evaluator. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished Toastmasters again. Distinguished Toastmaster Udankar, congratulations on completing your level 4 project 1 speech. When you began your speech, you started with way back in time, there was a tribe in dense Amazon forest. The power which you had in the beginning, the high pitch voice, made the audience so curious to know what is it you are going to bring to us. Every start is very important. And the title which you had, Tears of the Moon, was a very curious and a catchy one. Your style of speech today in this particular project was storytelling, and you ensured that you take all of us into a different world altogether through your speech. Now, coming to the main purpose of your project, managing the audience, you ensured that you answered immediately the question put forth by the audience, and you also ensured that you respectfully asked them to hold on. And then when you answered it a bit while, after a while, you did mention that particular person telling that you have answered that. So this shows that you have successfully served the purpose of this particular project. Now coming to the premise you were standing in, or sitting in fact, what you could have done is, I would first request you to stand up and deliver the speech. And while you were standing and delivering the speech, when you told way back in times, you could have just gone back to just show that you are back in time. And then when you told that after, when few centuries passed, you could have just come in front and told us that you're actually traveling in time, so that we, the audience, would know that you're actually going back and forth in time, so we could relate to the story in a better manner. And coming to your eye contact, I could see that most of the time it was on one corner of the screen and not to the camera, even though we agree that we are in front of a 6 to 7 inch screen, we should ensure that we have to have a continuous eye contact with the audience. And also, I would request you to remove your virtual background, because most of the time your hands were invisible when you raised it and was out of the frame. And when you mentioned that the princess actually felt sick, what you could have done is used a bit more voice modulation, telling that the princess was actually sick. You could have just lowered your voice or in a sad tone to ensure that we know that the princess is actually sick. And once when the audience asked, why was the princess sick? You told, I guess she had the cancer. It was your story and you knew why the princess was sick. So instead of you answering it, I guess you could have just told that the princess was suffering from this particular thing. And this is a repetitive speech, as I remember I had heard this before. And the evaluation given there was to work on your transition and voice modulation. So I would request you to work on the same with the help of your mentor for greater speeches in the future. Your pause of the voice in the beginning was great. Your pace in the end was a little bit rushed due to the red card, but your pitch was near to perfect. So if you work on all this, you'll have great speeches in the future projects. Thank you, and back to you, General Evaluator Toastmaster Krishnamurti.
Thank you, Bhavani. That was a wonderful evaluation. You have really done right on thing, and you also given excellent suggestions as well, you know. And as you rightly said, yes, a lot of audiences were trying to ask questions, interrupting him, but he has overcome nicely by talking to them. And going back forth, I think definitely that helps, you know, for the audience to understand the time in which he is telling the story, you know, all that stuff. And I also noticed, as you suggested rightly, that continuous eye contact was missing. I think that is one thing which FDT Mudanka can work on. It's going to be very, very nice story. And then voice modulation also you have suggested. I agree with you everything. You have covered almost everything, and it was a complete evaluation. I think a round of applause to you. her as well as the speaker DTM Mudaka. Now I request the rule takers to give the report. To start with, I will call upon timer Toastmaster Ujjwal. Ujjwal, are you there?
Yes, sir. Just a second.
No problem.
All right. A very happy evening once again to all the fellow Toastmasters and my dear guests. This session went up to 2 minutes. President has taken 4 minutes, 25 seconds. Southern Atoms has taken 2 minutes, 16 seconds. Secretary has taken 3 minutes. Master of Ceremonies, Toastmaster Gaurav, till now has taken 11 minutes. And then coming to the prepared speech session, Toastmaster Prakash has taken 5 minutes, 41 seconds. DTM Udanko has taken 15 minutes, 35 seconds. And then coming to the table topic session, it has gone up to 31 minutes and all the speakers have responded exceptionally well because 6 speakers have crossed 2 minutes and 6 speakers have crossed 1 minute and no speaker has gone below 1 minute. The speaker's individual timing goes like this. DTM AK Prabhakara took 2 minutes 40 seconds. Toastmaster Sai Snehal took 1 minute 44 seconds. Toastmaster Vijayapendra took 2 minutes 5 seconds. And then coming to Toastmaster Varaprasad has taken 3 minutes 29 seconds. Toastmaster Sanjana has taken 1 minute 42 seconds. Toastmaster Rashmi took 1 minute 31 seconds. Toastmaster Vaishnavi has taken 1 minute 3 seconds. Toastmaster Sandeep has taken 2 minutes, 4 seconds. And then our general evaluator, Toastmaster Krishnamurthy, has taken 1 minute, 38 seconds. And then Arundas has taken 1 minute, 35 seconds. And not but not the least, our the last speaker, Toastmaster Bhavani, has taken 2 minutes, 4 seconds. And then coming to evaluation, Toastmaster Sandeep has taken 3 minutes, 5 seconds. And Toastmaster Bhavani has taken 3 minutes, 43 seconds. Lastly, coming to the general evaluation session, till now, the general evaluator has taken 8 minutes, 42 seconds. Thank you, and back to general evaluator.
Ujjwal, you can stay on, and you can also continue your hour counter report as well.
Sure, sir, yeah. Once again, a very happy evening, fellow Toastmasters. By listening to this meeting, I'd like to appreciate both the prepared speakers, as the speakers have challenged themselves to cut down their overused words and filler sounds. And then coming to the table topic participants, I was just stunned by their response because today I literally struggled to get the overused words or filler sounds because they just did their job exceptionally, I would say, or rather they responded well. So kudos to both the speakers as well as the table topic speakers as well. Now coming to my report, Southern Atoms Toastmaster Vaishnavi has taken 1 hour, MC Toastmaster Gaurav has taken 1 hour, President Toastmaster Ankita has taken 2 hours, and then Grammarian Toastmaster Sanjana has taken 2 hours, PP Valiant, Coming to the prepared speech session, Toastmaster Prakash has taken 3 hours and crutch word and two times. Toastmaster Sandeep has taken 2 hours. And then coming to the second speaker, UT Mudanka, 2 hours, crutch word. There are 2 crutch words, but 3 times, so 2 times. Coming to evaluator, Toastmaster Bhavani, 2 hours. And then coming to the table topic speakers, Toastmaster Sanjana, 4 hours, 2 and 1 crutch word and 3 times. Toastmaster Rashmi, 3 hours. Toastmaster Vaishnavi, 2 hours. Toastmaster Sandeep, 1 hour, 1 crutch word and 2 times. And Toastmaster Krishnamurthy, Class, one crutch word, you know, two times. And then Toastmaster Arundas, two crutch words, you know, five times, and but four times. Coming to Toastmaster Bhavani, one crutch word, so two times. And till now, the gender evaluator has taken, he has made two hours. Yeah. Thank you, and over to the.
Thank you, Ujwal. I think he deserves a special round of applause for taking two tasks, you know, the timer role as well as our counter, which is not easy because he has to focus on both the things. Thank you very much, Ujwal. Now, coming to the grammarian, I request Sanjana to give a report.
Good evening again to fellow Toastmasters and esteemed guests. A man's grammar is like Caesar's wife, should not only be pure, but also above suspicion of impurity. As the grammarian of today's session, I have carefully listened to all your speeches and I have made a note of the good usages along with the not so good usages. To begin with the good usages, monthly periodicals, vaporate like a bubble, ground yourself, acknowledge, belly rumbling, huge change at macro level, double helix, devil is in the detail, sense of productivity, inspiration is internal, motivation is external, limelight, cease, and followed by the not so good usages. One of such kingdom is one of such kingdoms. Scratches in the body must be used as scratches on the body. After so long journey, the better way of you rephrasing the same is after such a long journey. She was pretty not sure. Should have been phrased as she wasn't sure. Local peoples is local people. Bullshit could have been avoided. Got sting is got stung. Got more anger is got angry. And that's it. And thank you. Back to you, the general evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sanjana. That was a very nice detailed report of the grammarian. Thank you very much.
So, one second. I missed out the word of the week. The word of the week was used by Toastmaster Prakash.
I think she deserves a round of applause. She's very meticulously kept all the records. Thank you very much. Parliamentary procedure evaluator, I request Toastmaster Varaprasad to give his report, please.
Evaluator, Mr. Evaluator Krishnamurthy. Today's session went well. There's no issues of any wrong uses of non-parliamentary or religion or sex or politics. And there's an opportunity, I say, people wherever possible go turn on their videos. I still see some members continuously keep video off, but there is an opportunity to work on that. Otherwise, meeting went well. Thank you, and back to you, Krishnamurthy.
Thank you, Prasad. I think, can we give another round of applause to all the role takers, because who make this week-on-week meeting so easy. Without their help, it would have not been possible. Thank you very much. Now, coming to the table topics, Shiva Prasad. We started, the topics were very nice, very interesting, but only my one suggestion I would give you is, of course, you initially explained what table topic is, how it is going to benefit each one of us, the Toastmaster, which was very nicely done. And the table topics were a little bit lengthy. If you can shorten it, and you know, and rather you should not be saying you do like this, you know, like for example, convince so and so. No, not like that. You just give the topic. Whether they convince or they talk against it, it is left to them. So that is the way you should do it. And another thing what I noticed is one of the role takers, for example, Ujwal, was not given the table topic. Instead of giving it to a GE, which he anyway, half an hour he has got time. So So I would request in future, of course, this is your first time you are doing it. These mistakes happen. It doesn't matter. But you can keep this in mind. Then, and another thing what I noticed is, you know, you are giving your opinion on how each one spoke. I think that can be avoided, because then people will go biased on your comment, so which you should avoid. Generally, give the topic, let them say, okay, thank you for your response. That's all we have to say. So whether good, bad, or who was the response, let the people who are going to vote, let them decide that. We should not be influencing on them. This is the only suggestion I have. Otherwise, you have done an excellent session on a debut table topic session. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Shiva. I think he deserves a round of applause from all of us. Now, coming back to the MC, Toastmaster Gaurav, who steered the meeting today. And Gaurav, you have such a meticulous, you planned everything. You have taken all the introduction of all the role takers, and you have introduced them very nicely. Really, you have done your job very well behind the scene. Only suggestion what I would, I have also given a couple of times earlier, but I'm ready to give once again. So what I request to you is to sorry, there is some obstacle coming in my computer. What I would suggest you is to look at the camera. You know, that's the only thing. If you can do that, you have excellent voice, you have excellent communication skills. You do really a lot of homework behind the scene, getting the introduction. And this is one of the excellent MC job you have done. But I want you to look at the camera as far as possible. And you know, it doesn't matter. One or two lines if you introduce also is good. Good enough. You don't have to. And then you also move back and forth too much, which can be avoided. I think with that, you will be a complete Toastmaster, I would say. So please try put some practice on that. I'm sure you will be able to improve on that. And you have also explained the Toastmaster is structure, everything you have done, and history of Toastmaster also, you have explained very well. That was very nice. So, you have done all the things very nicely you have done. MC is, all of you know it. It's you are like a thread holding the entire garland. So, you have done that excellently, exceedingly well. So kudos to you on that job. Overall, it was a successful meeting. And before I hand over the charge back to the MC, I would like to thank Sai, Toastmaster Sai Snail and the team, which did a very successful term. And now the Toastmaster Ankita and the new XCOM team, all the best. I'm sure Mekon is thriving very well and one of the popular Toastmaster club in Bangalore. Let us keep up this. Let us all strive to make it better and better in each meeting. As it progresses, I'm sure you will all, you are already doing it, very vibrant club. I have enjoyed my role as a GE. Thank you very much. And back to you, MC Gaurav, Toastmaster Gaurav, over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Krishnamurti, for that insightful general evaluation session. I'm sure the role takers will take all your suggestions and work on it from the next meeting onwards. So before I hand it over to the President Toastmaster Ankita, I'd like to end it with a quote. Sometimes life gives you an obstacle. An obstacle may seem unfair or it might be too extreme, but it is up to us whether to break the obstacle and find an opportunity or let the obstacles break you. That's a question to ask yourself. With this, I'd like to give the in charge back to the President Toastmaster Ankita.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Gaurav. Indeed, an amazing MC session. And we've had a very good meeting, a very good debutant table topic master as well.
Thank you so much for the insightful session by the GE today, Toastmaster Krishnamurthy. Thank you so much for all the insights you had to share on how the meeting went. We did face quite a few obstacles, but we have turned them all into learning opportunities. And here we are almost at the end of the meeting. I hope all the members present in the meeting have voted and submitted their ballot forms. We'll just wait for some time for the results to come in. Meanwhile, I would also request all the members to please profusely use Basecamp feedback. Do go ahead and provide the feedback on Basecamp. Since we are back to online meetings, we don't really get to see each other anymore. The only best way you can encourage people to come up and speak and continue to take roles is by giving them feedback. So please use that platform, give feedback. You have SciSnails tutorial at your disposal. If you still don't know how to do it, please, you can call us and we'll help you out, but please do go ahead and give feedback on Basecamp. Can I request the Sergeant at Arms to please send in the results for the awards for today? Vaishnavi, are you in the meeting? Can you please respond?
Can I just read out the winner?
Sorry?
Can I just read it out?
You know, share it with me, Vaishnavi. Can you please share it with me? Vaishnavi, you can just send me a screenshot maybe if. Okay, so the results are in. The best evaluator goes to the newly installed secretary and the air director, Toastmaster Bhavani. A round of applause for her, please. The best table topic response goes to, of course, I think we all don't have to even announce this anymore, to distinguished Toastmaster A.K. Prabhakara. The best prepared speech goes to Toastmaster Prakash. The best minor role taker in the TAPG roles goes to the VPPR of our club and also one who comes up with very innovative quotes when she is giving any of these TAPG roles, Toastmaster Sanjana. And the best major role taker for the day is our debutant table topic master, Toastmaster Shiva. Congratulations to all the winners. And now I officially close meeting number 1144. I would request all of you to just stay back for a group photo. Vaishnavi, could you please sound your video? Okay. Done. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. So you're on mute. You're on mute, sir.
For announcement, typically being done that they should take a look at the video tomorrow or next day for their own performance. You got my point? I think am I heard?
So can you please repeat? I didn't really understand what you said.
The video link will be published tomorrow, perhaps. Request members to take a look at their own performance. Not only evaluation, but they should take a look at their own performance, whether they understand what they have spoken, can they improve themselves, in what way they can examine it themselves. It helps improvement beyond the feedback that is given there by the evaluator. So you have to make it saying, take a look at the video, your own video in YouTube. Link will be sent next day or whatever you want to, you have to say. Wow, here is a great Sandeep's kid.
Can you lift him up?
Yeah, great.
So cute.
Okay, bye-bye. Good night.
Bye, sir.
There's always next time. Sai, perhaps you have to mentor, hand over a few things to the way it has to be to the individuals to keep up the tradition.
Yes, sir, I'll do that.
You have to do that. And Badri, I'll call you later about the newsletter.
Okay, sir. Sure.
Just to fix this for next time so that you hand it over to the next person in such a way that some errors are taken care and you have to hand it over in such a way that that person also does it with the same enthusiasm the way you have done it.
Sir, Bhatt sir is not coming.
Bhatt's wife had a surgery, eye surgery. So perhaps he has to put eye drops every half an hour or something. It's a continuous process. So he's on that job. And I think one more eye has to go. Another eye also has to be there. There's one more surgery waiting for her, for the other eye.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Thank you, sir.
Guys, I just wanted to ask, what were the few glitches that
one second,
we...
One second.
Yeah, stop the recording first. Gaurav, you are the co-host.
I'm from tablet. I don't know how to stop recording.
Who is from phone?
Okay, figure it out.
Ankita.